guys, welcome back once again. So at this point, I'm here in Stuttgart, and right behind me, what you see is the station. There's an U-Bahn station or S-Bahn station for University of Stuttgart. By the way, I'm joined here by RK.
Hello.
He is taking us around the University of Stuttgart's campus tour. But before we go ahead, why don't you introduce yourself? Yeah. What do you do here?
My name's RK, studying the master's program in Water Resource Engineering and Management. I've been here since 2018, and I'm happy to give you a campus tour.
Perfect, let's start. So I just checked with RK, this is actually S-Bahn, the surface train, not the underground train. And also this was a train I took straight from the airport, which brought me here straight away.
That's true.
My question then comes for you is, if somebody who's traveling from India, what is the nearest airport and what is the best way to reach Stuttgart?
Okay, there are basically two possibilities. The first possibility is to come to Frankfurt, and the second possibility is to directly come through Stuttgart. The flights are cheaper to travel to Frankfurt. In Frankfurt, you can take the Hauptbahnhof, take a ICE train, come to Stuttgart, Stuttgart Hauptbahnhof, and then you can take the S1, S2 or S3 to come to Feigen. If you're taking the second option, which is Stuttgart, then you have a basic train that comes from the airport to Feigen, and it takes roughly 15 minutes.
The train, what you just saw, straight comes from airport.
Yeah.
Right? Hauptbahnhof means main station. Okay. Yep. And for trains from Frankfurt, the way he came, you can book that ticket from Deutsche Bahn's website. You can use this train, ICE. It's an intercity express train. The ticket price from Frankfurt Hauptbahnhof to Stuttgart Hauptbahnhof can range anywhere between 15 to 25 euro. That's a range. If you're talking about the station where you're supposed to get off, it's the Universität. The University of Stuttgart has two main campus. Why don't you talk about it?
Yeah, so there's the first, the city center campus. The city center campus is generally for the German thought programs. There are some international programs like IUSD and also ITEC and Geoinformatics. But the Feigen campus is mainly revolved around engineering-based master's program.
Which campus are we going today?
Right now we are traveling through the campus Feigen.
RK, here in Germany, what I've noticed is you need to have a accommodation by which then that house contract will help you to get your Anmeldung done, the city registration.
Yeah.
And with that city registration paper, you can unblock the blocked account, yes, what you've got from India.
Correct.
In that meantime, how much cash I should have for my ease of life here?
To be on the safer side, anywhere around 500 to 1000 euros, something that you can get by cash or by a Forex card.
Forex card, maybe generally like 1000 euros is sufficient, I guess?
Yeah, probably. Right now, out of the S-Bahn, the university starts immediately here. If you walk towards this side, it's towards the bibliothek. And then if you walk behind, you get the student office and the machine and bau department along with the civil engineering department. We're going to start with the library here first.
As RK said, as soon as you're out of this station, immediately the university starts. Every building around what we see here belongs to University of Stuttgart. Bear in mind one thing, this university is pretty vast. They're not just in one spot, so we'll only be covering things which are relevant.
We right now came out the S-Bahn station this side, and the university bibliothek is right behind us.
Right, so this is where library is. As soon as you come out, this big gigantic stone, a piece of art, is also a landmark as soon as you come out. Where are we going now?
Right now we are heading towards the student office department.
And what work we can get done from there?
Most of the registration work with respect to you being a student is done there.
So if you freshly arrive here in this university, that's a very important office for you to visit.
Yes. So right now we are, behind us is the student office. And in the student office, for you to get your student card and anything relating exams, it will be done right here. And right opposite to it is the infrastructure planning department. It is also called as the civil engineering department, and anything that is required with respect to civil engineering is in this building. So the next one will be to move towards the information science building and also the bus stop.
Okay, so that building what you see is an informatic building?
Yes.
Computer science building?
Yes, correct.
And then right next to that there's a bus stop. Let us show you the bus stop first, then we move towards the informatic building.
This is the informatic building where the Infotech course and also the computer science course takes place, and right now we are at the bus stop. The bus stop leads to Feingen and also the Hauptbahnhof. The Feingen can lead you to all the nearby grocery shops like Aldi, Kaufland and things like that.
That was the student office. This is a civil engineering department. As soon as you walk from there, this is where the bus stop is. This is where the informatic building is. Arkit, do you want to tell us what programs are taught here, the English program? I mean, there could be a lot of programs, but the ones which you know or you have friends studying here.
So like Nikhilesh previously mentioned, there are two campuses. There's the StartMeta campus, which is around 15 minutes from the campus Feingen that we are at right now. In the campus Feingen, we have a number of English taught programs that are basically master's programs. There's the infrastructure planning, the water resource engineering and management course that I'm studying right now. There's the waste, physics, and there's also computational mechanics. And then other English taught programs, around 10 to 15 of them. In campus StartMeta, there are a number of English taught programs. That's mainly the IUSD, iTech. As far as my knowledge, these are the programs. There are also other programs that are offered.
So we went all the way on the other side of the university. Again, we are crossing the bibliothèque. Actually, one second. It's raining. The struggle is real.
This is the cafeteria that we are looking right now. And there's also Mensa. Food is generally offered for lunch. And the cafeteria is normally open till around 4 p.m. Here, we are looking at a 7-story building. This is for the pure science department, physics, chemistry and biology. We are right now moving towards the accommodation places, and it's around 4-minute walk from the S-Bahn itself.
What's the name of the accommodation, different accommodation?
There's Almendring, Pfaffenhof, Straussi.
This is where RK was explaining that this is the science building. We just came walking across this bridge, what you see. And as soon as you're on the other side, we're going to show you there is a IZ building, what you see right behind. We're going to take you there. It's a very important building. If you're studying here, and this whole area is filled with accommodation. There are three different accommodations. I mean, if you're someone new to this term of Studentenwerk, they provide accommodation at a very subsidized price, anywhere ranging between 250 to 300, depending on the kind of facility you have in the housing. This is where I was talking, and now we are going towards the IZ. There's a huge cluster of different accommodation here. Alright, so right now we are in the IZ building. First of all, what does IZ stands for?
IZ stands for International Zentrum. They support mainly international students.
Okay, what offices are there in this building?
There are a number of offices in this building. It starts from initially the intercultural training, and then there's a building for supporting you with respect to financial assistance and things like that. Once you finish with your admission, the details will be sent to you by the department for registering for the buddy program. The buddy program is offered by the International Zentrum. There will be a student that will help you through the initial process or initial days.
Like as basic as picking you up from the station or airport until you are sitting in your accommodation or arranging an accommodation for you. Till getting your city registration done, because that is a sheet of paper required to unblock your blocked account, right? And that can never happen unless you have a house contract with you.
True.
Right? See, this was just a short, crisp video from Feingen campus. There's also a city center campus there.
Yeah.
But as RK already explained that, there are programs taught here, there are programs taught there. He studies here, that's why he was more confident about this space.
Yes.
Right? Any last thought of yours before we end this video?
University of Stuttgart is a great place to study, and you definitely have good support from the Indian Student Association here. And I wish you all the best for applying through the process, and hope you guys get through.
Not just that, but the life outside university is pretty awesome here. There are some of the biggest companies' headquarters right here in this city, like Mercedes-Benz, Daimler, like Porsche, Bosch.
Yes.
And there may be other companies also definitely here. I mean, what I'm seeing, because I don't stay here, I stay in Berlin, I'm visiting for the first time. everywhere there are offices, everywhere,
yes.
Right?
Yes, yes. Both of them are our alumni, Robert Bosch and also Daimler. They're alumni from University of Stuttgart.
Yeah, they studied here at some point.
Yeah.
And it's pretty historic university, you know, dating way back. So anyway, so this is what we just wanted, a glimpse of the university. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that thumbs up button and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.
Okay. See you.